What's the most ridiculous reason for which you've been dumped? Made a girl smile too much. She had braces and it cut up the inside of her mouth. I wish I still had the text. Long story short, she was mad I didn't grab her ass. In public. On our first date. I'm not ready for a relationship. I thought it was a bad time to bring that up since we were engaged and had been together for almost 2 years. The girl told me she thought this boy who she had a crush on for a long time was gonna ask her out. She said this to me. Her then BF. After going out with this guy for 6 months, I asked him if we were dating and he immediately ghosted me. She found out the truck I was driving was owned by my mom. Twin complex. Her twin got jealous. She was the older sister of her twin sibling. They came from a conservative and sheltered family. I was her first boyfriend. She wasn't going to school, summer break, or have a working at that moment. When we first started going out, her younger twin sister would text her nonstop. Then she would make up excuses that her stomach hurts and ask her to come home. I tried to talk to her younger sister and she definitely made it seem like I was stealing her property away. I made a compromise with her to see her at least once a week. I was making time for her even though I was working full-time while she had no job, school. In the end, her sister's jealousy made it impossible to develop any kind of healthy relationship with her. They were both 23 at the time, and would spend most of their time cosplaying, dressing up as anime characters. The weirdest part was they would often dress as the couples in the anime and even Photoshop themselves kissing, making out. So yay, I was attracted to her kindness, since her sister was actually a really caring person. But it turns out there was a reason why they never dated. One of my exes dumped me saying that he wanted to be like Paul from the Bible. She thought I killed her horse. It wasn't actually her horse. With voodoo, it hung itself because I was jealous. It was a horse. Apparently, I gave her too much anxiety when I bought her a coffee that one morning and she broke up with me the same week. The guy the first was dating broke up with me cause he had family problems. I was all like, I'm so sorry, I'm here if you need me. 2 days later I find out he lied and asked out one of my best friends and she said yes. About a week later I asked him why he dumped me and he left me on read. Not me but one of my friends who's a senior in high school got dumped by her boyfriend who she dated for almost 2 years. He dumped her because he didn't want to go to the school dance. A few days later he texted her to tell her that he wanted to get back together but she declined. He could have just told her that he didn't want to go and still be here with her or just go to the stupid dance. When I was 12 we played spin the bottle and I made a kissy moi sound before we kissed. An hour later she sent her best friend to my soccer game to break up with me. My boyfriend broke up with me because he was moving away to go to puppet school. My ex's cat was named Ben. The girl I was dating's cat was named Bundles. One day, I called Bundles Ben. She asked me what I just called her cat. I thought about it, and then remembered that was my ex's cat's name. I laughed and told her and she was super unimpressed. Broke up with me the next day. God told me not to date you. I'm sorry, and guess what? This happened twice. With two different girls. Shared this before here, but this has and will always take the cake for me. College GF's dad won $1 million in the state lottery over winter break. Broke up with me over the phone, telling me, now that I'm rich, I can't afford to date regular people like you. That's really the only thing wrong. You're just regular. Dumped might be extreme. But on a first date, girl asked me to go buy her popcorn literally as the movie started. So I did. Whispered as I was getting up. You want butter on that? Brought it back and she says. Is there butter on this? I said. Yes. I asked and you said. Yeah. And she said. No. I specifically said. Nah. I thought she was joking or something. It was like a Seinfeld bit. So I said. Well. Maybe this just isn't going to work out. And she said, I think you're right. Thanks for nothing. and fucking left, but she took my popcorn. She should have thanked me for fucking that. Ugh, I don't feel a spark of anything when we kiss anymore. At that time I got hit in the mouth with a bat and couldn't kiss her for the past month. If you didn't want to be with me, just say it, or at least come up with a better lie to dump me over. He dumped me because I cheated on him. In his dream, I was dating a guy whose parents didn't like me. It was a long-distance relationship, and so we mostly chatted online but also made occasional phone calls. So we were talking on the phone, and at one point I said, "You shouldn't have to choose between me and your parents." The conversation continued. We decided to break up. We stayed friends, something like 10 years later. We were talking online when the subject of our breakup came up. Turns out he thought I had said, "You should have to choose between me and your parents," and decided that he wasn't going to do that. I would never give someone that kind of ultimatum. That would be ridiculous. It blew my mind that a single misheard word caused us to break up. And we didn't realize it for 10 years. On the surface, it sounded okay. My GF and I were kinda fizzling out. But when she dumped me, she said it was because I was not religious enough. She wanted to go to church every Sunday and for major religious holidays. I was okay with her going, but I was conflicted about religion at the time, so I didn't want to go. So that is what she said when she dumped me. Seems like a decent reason. What made it ridiculous is that about 6 months later, she was dating the president of the college atheist group. Not dumped, but shut down. I asked her out and she sort of freaked. Like, on a date? A date? Oh shit, I want to say yes, but I can't. Every time I've dated a guy, the first like we ended up hating each other. But I want to, but I can't. So, I know, you're my gay friend, I can't date you. Because you're gay. Awesome. I have a gay friend now. Oh shit. I'm late for class. Bye. Quote dot. I was like, what? What the fuck just happened? The other people of our social group were similarly confused. I'm a Gemini. I said, love you. She got mad I forgot the I. We were 14 and I wore a tank top for the first time in his presence. Turned out I had way more cleavage than he was comfortable with and he dumped me over the phone. Apparently, we didn't come from the same planet. Closing parenthesis. Dated a chick in my early 20s. We partied a lot at the time. One night I refused to get into her car and go for the drive home since we were obliterated. She got upset. Said, fuck you this guy, I'll be fine on my own. Receive a call from her 36 hours later. She'd been bailed out of jail already. This guy, you are a fucking asshole. It's your fault I went to jail. I am breaking up with you. I hung up and giggled. Cunt, we have to break up. I mean, we can't even get married. You're allergic to fish. Quote, she chose the occasional tuna sandwich over me. I laughed and still tell the story, so I guess it's a win. She wanted to pity date a guy to not hurt his feelings. Even though her and I were exclusive. Temporarily before she would let him down kindly. Spoiler alert, it just ended in two pissed off guys and a sad girl. Edit, speak of the devil. She just contacted me again. Today. Edit 2, timeline. She spent a week apologizing to me with me basically ripping her a new one every time we made contact. After that, I started working out, and I'm already in decent shape. But I lost 10 pounds and decreased my body fat percent from 16% to 13%. The goal, in this quarantine, is 10%, and I'm getting there. It's been 4 months or so, and now we're at a today. When she contacted me again, she wanted to apologize, because she feels terrible. I don't have much ill will in my heart for her because I'm over it. Mainly. So I just told her that if she really wants to clear her conscience, for her to tell the other guy she wasn't serious about him. Or I would tell him, if she kept contacting me. End of story. Y'all, I hope everyone's staying safe in quarantine, and that the people who are bashing my religion learn to chill out and accept each other's heart. I was too clingy. She got mad every time I hung out with anyone that wasn't her. You're too normal. And then she went back with her ex. An ex-convict pusher who thinks that a shiner is an act of love. My fifth grade boyfriend dumped me over Xbox Live. My first girlfriend told me once that I loved my dog more than her. I said that I did and she didn't talk to me for a week. Which at the time felt like an eternity. We ended up getting back together for another month. She broke up with me because she found these guys at the flea market who were hitting on her. Gave them my number. And they called to fight for her. I said no. I, a 14-year-old, wouldn't take her, a 14-year-old virginity in a Burger King bathroom. Welcome to Ireland. I love you so much and want to spend the rest of my life with you. We have to break up. If it's really meant to be, then we will end up together again like they do in the movies. Because I wouldn't drop the restraining order on him. Apparently me calling the police on him to get him out of my house. Putting a restraining order on him because he was trying to kill me. And then calling the police on him when he broke the restraining order didn't mean we broke up. It took standing in front of a judge to extend my restraining order for him to tell me. Whatever, bitch. It's over. Because I guess I was just joking with everything else, face with rolling eyes. A girl I dated texted me that I wanted a relationship and she's not really up for that right now. It was actually because she was taller than me and was afraid of what people would think. I met my wife a week later. TL, doctor dated a blind girl who, after refusing to put a label on our relationship, ignored me for over 6 months and then said the reason was because during that 6 months he was leaving hints in Snapchat stories that I should message her to meet up, e.g. someone make plans soon. I dated a blind girl. We had a pretty close relationship. She was very independent, but after a while I could help her with certain things she found difficult. She always has some issues. She said she wasn't really ready for a relationship. And then about a week later she walked me to the train station before I went to an event, and as I was saying goodbye, I went for the hug and she kissed me hella passionately. I was like, okay, neat. We acted as if we were together after that. Slept together, met the parents, said I love you, etc. But anytime I called her my girlfriend or said that I was her boyfriend, she was like, no, you're not. I spoke to her about it and said that it hurt and I didn't understand why the label was such a sticking point for her. She said fair enough and all that. And then it switched to being, you're not my boyfriend yet, but you will be. Okay, whatever. And then she just started phasing me out completely. I would ask her if she was okay and she would leave me unread. It took a long time, but I cut myself off and sorted myself out. And then about 6 months later, I just started dating my current GF. And me and the ex had a chat over Snapchat. She basically asked why I hadn't talked to her. And I was just like, you wouldn't let me. She said I'd hurt her and that she'd been leaving stuff on her Snapchat story that hinted I should message her. Things like, someone should make plans soon, and can't wait for summer. Everyone hit me up to make plans. It was implied that was where things went wrong, LMAO. I got dumped because the headlights on my car didn't come on automatically when I started my car. I'm assuming he had other reasons. But this is what I was told. And I love laughing at it. This happened when I was 21. And the girl was 22. She was Hispanic. And I'm white. We were in the phase before a relationship. So I guess we were seeing each other? Anyways, we got along great. And to this day, I still think she is just an amazing person with a heart of gold. We were out to eat one night at Applebee's. And the conversation of food came up. We discussed our favorite foods. What we didn't like, etc. She mentioned something about trying new things. Specifically things like Rocky Mountain oysters, bull testicles, frog legs, etc. I'm a relatively picky eater, admittedly, so I told her I didn't think that I could try any of those things. The rest of the night went on just fine, and I didn't think anything of it. A couple nights later, when I was talking to her on the phone, She said she didn't think we should see each other anymore. Because she believed that I'm prejudiced against other people's cultures because I won't try any of their traditional foods. I was kind of blown away. But she had already made her mind up. So I wasn't going to stop her. I still keep in touch with her from time to time. Even though she now lives 3,000 miles away. TLDR. Girl dumped me because I wouldn't eat bull testicles. Two stories for this one. Not sure which is more ridiculous. Because I didn't want to wake up out of a dead sleep at 3 a.m. and walk 2 miles in the cold spring weather to go to a fucking elementary school so she could use the swing set. Because I said Scarlett fucking Johansson was pretty. As if I would in any life have a chance with her. We were dating for 3 to 4 months and I came over while he was on acid and then a couple days later he told me that while stripping he realized I was the antagonist in his life and that we're breaking up upside down face.